Hi everyone, welcome to Smart Everyday Overlearning. How are you all? I hope you are all doing good. Today's session is the continuation topic from the yesterday's topic. Already two sessions completed of solved examples from chemistry, atomic structure, some solved examples. Who didn't see previous two classes, I'll give the link in the description. You can go through that classes. Dear students, we'll start our today's session. Some solved example of chemistry, atomic structure. Let us see with the first question. Which of the following is an isoelectronic species? Isoelectronic species. First of all, you have to know the definition of isoelectronic species. That means the chemical species or a molecular species which are having the same number of electrons are known as isoelectronic species. That means, see students, here we are having some ions, the species we are having here, and if you calculate the number of electrons of these, you should get only one number. You should get only the same number, then that species is known as isoelectronic species. Let's do the first one. CO plus, CN plus and NO minus C2. And students, here if you do the calculation for this CO, that means one carbon and one oxygen. See students, for the carbon atomic number 6 and oxygen atomic number 8. That means 8 plus 6, that is 14. So CO is having 14 electrons here. That means the atomic number and the number of electrons must be same. That means the same number, so that here 14 electrons. And if you see the next one, CN plus, for that carbon and nitrogen. Carbon atomic number 6 plus nitrogen is 7, so that 7 electrons are present. Here students, if you see, N plus is there, so that you need to do minus 1 for this. That means 12 electrons. Enough. For CO plus, we got here 14 electrons, and CN plus we got here 12 electrons. So the electrons number is different here. So option A is wrong answer. For this, we can start with option B. Option B, we are having CO and CN. Let's do with CO, C and O, carbon and oxygen. Carbon 6 electrons plus oxygen 8 electrons. That means the number is 14. So CO has 14 electrons. Okay students, and now for CN, only for C and N, carbon atom and nitrogen atom. 6 plus 7, that means 13 electrons. So students, CN has 13 electrons. So here the number varies, so that second option also wrong. Let's start with the next one. Option C, what we are having here, option C, CO and CN minus and NO plus and C2, 2 minus. So for these all, we can do the electrons, how many electrons are there, we can calculate for that. Let's start. C and O, again you should do that. Atomic number of carbon is 6 plus oxygen is 8. Your total is 14 electrons. That means CO has 14 electrons. And CN minus, carbon 6 plus nitrogen 7, and you should take plus 1 here. So 6 plus 8, that should be 14 electrons. So students, for the first and second, CO and CN minus, you got here 14 electrons. Let's see the third one, that is NO plus. NO plus, in that nitrogen and oxygen, 2 atoms are present. For nitrogen, atomic number 7, so that number of electrons also 7. For oxygen, atomic number 8, so that the number of electrons also 8. For this, 7 plus 8, that is 15, minus 1, that is 14. Why? Because minus 1 here, NO plus cation has formed here, so that NO plus, you should do like this, minus 1. And number, last one, C2, 2 minus. C means carbon. Carbon atomic number. Carbon atomic number, 6 here, so that 6 number of electrons also 6. Here 2 atoms of carbon present, so 6 into 2. 6 into 2. Here 2 minus, so that you need to add 2 here. 12 plus 2, 14. So that C2 2 minus has 14 electrons here. So option C, if you are doing the calculation of the electrons, that is isoelectronic species, these are all having 14 electrons for this. So option C is the correct one. This is isoelectronic species, so you no need to go for the option D. Let's see the second question. A 0.66 kilogram ball is moving with a speed of 100 meter per second. The associated wavelength will be. Dear students, in this question we need to calculate the associated wavelength. Here the Planck's constant value also they have given in the question itself, 6.66 into 10 power minus 34 joule per second. And some options they have given. Let us see which one is the correct one. For this answer, you need to know about the de Broglie wave equation. Dear students, de Broglie's wave equation. From this wave equation, we should get lambda is equal to h by mv. This is the formula from de Broglie's wave equation. And here the given h value, 6.66 into 10 power minus 34. And the mass they have given here. Mass means just like m is equal to 0.66 kg. And velocity, that means a speed of the ball, velocity they have given, that is 100 meter per second. If you substitute these three values in this formula, you should get the answer. The lambda is equal to the h value, 6.6 into 10 power minus 34 by m value, that means mass. Mass is 0.66 into velocity is nothing but 100. And students, for this 6.6 into 10 power minus 34 by 0.66 into, for this 100 you need to write just like this 10 square. For the calculation, if you cancel these two, it should be 10 here. And students, the answer is 10 into 10 power minus 34 into 10. It can be transferred like this, then it will become into 10 power minus 2. Then the answer is 10 into 10 power minus 36. And here the power is 1, then the answer is 10 power minus 35 meters. Then students, if you see the options for this, option C, 10 power minus 35 meters, that is the correct answer. Let's see the third question. The maximum number of electrons in a subshell of an atom is determined by the following. Here formula they have given 2L plus 1, 4L minus 2, 2N square and 4L plus 2. Let us see which one is the correct one. For a given shell, L, the given shell is L and the number of subshells, that means ML is equal to 2L plus 1, this is the formula for ML. Since each subshell can accommodate 2 electrons of opposite spin,
the spin will be like this, opposite spin. So the maximum number of electrons in a subshell, subshell maximum number of electrons, the formula will be 2 into 2L plus 1, and that is 4L plus 2. So option D, 4L plus 2, that is the correct answer. Let's see the next one. Question number 4. If uncertainty in the position and momentum are equal, then uncertainty in velocity is. Options they have given. Which one is the correct one? Let us see. For this question, students, you need to know about the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. It is possible to determine the position and the momentum of subatomic particle simultaneously and accurately. And this uncertainty principle is applicable to microscopic particles, for larger the uncertainty becomes insignificant. And here formula they have given, delta x into delta p greater than or equal h by 4 pi. These are the constant values. Here delta x is uncertainty in the position, and delta v is the velocity, uncertainty in the velocity. Delta p is uncertainty in the momentum, and m is the mass of the particle. And students, to determine the exact position of the electron, we use different radiations of extremely small wavelengths. So if you know all these things, if you know this formula, you can get the answer for that question. Basing upon that formula, you can get like this, or m delta v square is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. This is from delta x is equal to delta p, from that equation. And this we can also write like this, delta v is greater than or equal to 1 by 2m root h by pi. This is the formula for this, and it will be from option C, from the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Just you can derive this type of equation. Let's start question number 5. The measurement of the electron position is associated with an uncertainty in momentum, which is equal to 1 into 10 power minus 18 gram centimeter second inverse. The uncertainty in the electron velocity is. Then mass they have given here, mass of the electron 9 into 10 power minus 28 grams. And in these four options, let's see which one is the correct one for this answer. Uncertainty in the momentum, that formula is m delta v, that is equal to 1 into 10 power minus 18 gram centimeter second inverse. They have given in the question itself, so that uncertainty in the velocity, that should be delta v. Then students, you need to substitute this value. Then if you take the uncertainty in the momentum, that is m delta v value here, and by the mass of the electron, what they have given in the question, then it should be 10 power plus 28 here. And 1 by 9, that value must be 0.11. And students, for this, 1.1 into 10 power 9 centimeter second inverse. Then the option is 1 into 10 power 9 centimeter second inverse, that is option C is the correct answer. For coming to the sixth question, the orientation of an atomic orbital is governed by. That means these are all the quantum number, students, and the first one n, it indicates the principal quantum number, principal quantum number. And this is second one, azimuthal quantum number. Here ms means spin quantum number, and ml is magnetic quantum number. Let us see each one of them, which one tells about what are the aspects of the electron. Let us see. The principal quantum number represents the name and the size and energy of the shell to which the electron belongs. And the second one, azimuthal quantum number, describes the spatial distribution, the distribution of the electron cloud. That means in this electron cloud, the electron where it will be. And the magnetic quantum number describes the orientation or distribution of the electron cloud. And last one, the spin. The third one, spin quantum number, represents the direction of the spin, electron spin around its own axis. Direction of the spin around its own axis. And the orientation of atomic orbitals is governed by option D, the magnetic quantum number. Let's see the next question. The main axis of a diatomic molecule is Z. The molecular orbital px and py overlap to form which of the following orbitals? By overlapping, the which of the following orbital can be formed? Here see options: pi molecular orbital, sigma molecular orbital and delta molecular orbital, and no bond can be formed. Let us see. For this, for pi overlapping, the lobes of the atomic orbitals are perpendicular to the line joining the nuclei. That means, let us see clearly. If you see the pi molecular orbital, which will be plus and minus, this is px orbital. And here a bond should form. And another one, if you take, this is plus and minus, and this is py. And by overlapping, here one and here one. This is known as pi overlap. Hence, only sidewise overlapping, that is lateral overlapping, takes place. If you take this orbital like this, and another one should be like this. That means lateral overlapping. So the formed orbital can be pi molecular orbital. And here see the sigma. Sigma means sidewise, side by side overlapping. Like this, the orbitals can be overlapped. Okay, the option A will be correct. And see the next one. The following quantum numbers are possible for how many orbitals here? Values they have given: n is equal to 3, l is equal to 2, and m is plus 2. And from this table, you know that for the subshells SPDF, you are having the L value 0, 1, 2, and 3. So, L is equal to 2. Here L value 2, that subshell should be D subshell. Symbolizes one of the 5 D orbitals. From D orbitals, N is equal to 3, so that it should be 3D. Then D orbital means it is having 5 orbitals again: D XY, DYZ, DZX, and DX square, Y square, and here DZ square. If you take the values of this, 0, minus 1 and minus 2, here plus 1 and plus 2. These are the M value, M is equal to. So that the orbital has only one orbital, that is 3D orbital. The next question: who modified Bohr's theory by introducing elliptical orbits for electron path? And what the options they have given? The first one, Rutherford, and the second one, Thomson, and third one, Hund's rule and Sommerfeld. Let us see one by one. Which one is the correct for the elliptical orbits electron path? What they have given in the option, that is first one, Rutherford's experiment. See students, Rutherford model of the nuclear model here, that is atom discovery of nucleus. And this is scattering experiment. This is known as alpha scattering experiment here. So this option is the wrong one. Why? Because this completely belongs to alpha particle, Rutherford scattering experiment. Then the second option is Thomson, J.J. Thomson. So that this is the picture indicates the Thomson model of an atom. Here see the positive sphere and negative electrons, and these are indicates the protons, and minus these are all electrons. So Thomson also wrong. Option C about Hund's rule. Electron pairing in orbital starts only when all available empty orbitals of the same energy, nothing but degenerating orbitals, are singly occupied. Okay students, if you see the example for this, first one orbital singly occupied, then only the second orbital will join here. Unpaired electron in the 2p orbital are shown with parallel spins. So hence also the wrong answer for this question. Let us go through the next one. E. Sommerfeld atomic theory. Elliptical orbits for an electron addition to circular orbits to explain the fine spectrum. We can see here the elliptical orbits in the diagram. Elliptical foci, those are n values and l values also they have given here. And students, for this question, for the last question, who modified Bohr's theory by introducing elliptical orbits for electron path, that is Sommerfeld. Why? Because these are the elliptical model of the orbital. And okay students, let's recall what we have learned here today's session. First about isoelectronic species, and second the wavelength calculation, and next one maximum number of electrons of a subshell, and Heisenberg's uncertainty principle also explained in this class. Basing upon that, some problems we did. And for the next one, measurement of the electron position, the uncertainty momentum they have given, the answer we did, and the orientation of the atomic orbitals governed by about four quantum numbers, and about the four quantum numbers I explained. And the next one about pi molecular orbital, the main axis, diatomic molecules, for this explain the problem, and the following quantum numbers and are possible for how many orbitals also explained. And about the last one, Rutherford theory, Thomson and Hund's rule, and Sommerfeld experiment also I shown you in this class. Okay students, this is about our today's session. About 10 questions, some solved examples of chemistry in atomic structure. So I hope you have understood this topic, these 10 questions. You can practice these 10 questions. These are helpful to your NEET. So students, those who are like this class and those who are understand this class, you can share to your friends and you can subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much. And click the bell icon for my further updates. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching.